Who was Vivekananda? A saint? A patriot? A humanitarian? Is he still relevant today? In 1892, an unknown monk, a disciple of Ramakrishna Paramhansa, sat in thought at Kanyakumari. He had traveled all over India for 4 years. His heart bled over the poverty and misery of the masses. In his own words, he could not restrain his tears on seeing what he had seen. He hit upon a plan to spread the message of India to the world and raise the suffering millions of his country to their past glory. On 11th of September 1893, at the World Parliament of Religions in Chicago, this monk from a slave country stood to address the world. When he opened his lecture with the words,
"Sisters and brothers of America,"
when he pronounced the idea, "We believe not only in universal tolerance, but we accept all religions as true," the vision for the next century was laid. He became an instant rage. Yes, he was a missionary, but he did not convert. No surprise, a Jewish, on hearing him, remarked, "After hearing him, I realized that my religion was also true." Vivekananda's words and presence brought Asia to the West decisively. After lecturing for years in USA and UK, Vivekananda returned to India. He had to arise and awake a nation which felt like a slave under the shadows of the British and the West. "I discard the idea that India was ever passive. The great proof of this activity is that our most ancient and magnanimous race still lives. Her might no one can overcome." Exhorted, "Our country requires heroes. Be heroes. Stand firm like a rock. What India wants is a new electric fire to stir up a fresh vigor in the national veins. Be brave. Be brave. Man dies but once." He told the youth, "All power is within you. You can do anything and everything. Believe in that. Do not believe that you are weak. If you have faith in all the 330 millions of your gods and still have no faith in yourselves, there is no salvation for you. It is a man-making religion that we want. It is man-making education that we want.